Hello friends, welcome back to the Design Patterns video series. In this video, I'm going to discuss how to implement the Thread-safe Singleton Design Pattern in C# with examples. Please watch our previous video before proceeding to this video where we discussed why do we need to create the Singleton class as a shield. At the end of this video, you will understand the following pointers. What is Thread-safe in Singleton Design Pattern? What is lazy initialization in the Singleton Design Pattern, how to use multiple threads in Singleton Design Pattern, how to implement the Singleton Design Pattern in a thread-safe manner, implementation of thread-safe Singleton Design Pattern using locks, and double-check locking approach for thread-safe Singleton Design Pattern in C#. Let us directly move to Visual Studio to understand all these concepts. This is the example that we have worked on so far. The class is created with the shield keyword to restrict further inheritance, right? The constructor is created with the private access specifier to restrict the object creation from outside the class. We also created the get instance property as static as well as public so that we can access this property from outside the class by using the class name. This get instance property will take the responsibility to create and return an instance of the singleton object. But the way we have implemented the get instance property is not thread safe in a multi-threaded environment. Let us prove this. Let us move to the program class, right? Let us first create two methods, print teacher details and print student details. Right. As you can see, in each method I am doing the same thing, that is calling the get instance property of the singleton class to get the singleton instance and then calling the print details method on the singleton instance, right? Once we have created these two methods, let us invoke these methods parallelly. To invoke methods parallelly, I'm going to use the concept of parallel programming, that is parallel.invoke method. This concept is introduced in .NET framework 4.0 and if you are new to parallel programming, then I will provide the link in the video description section from where you can learn parallel programming in C# with real-time examples. So let us invoke print teacher details and print student details method parallelly using parallel.invoke method. So in our example, we are using the parallel.invoke method to call the print student details and print teacher details method parallelly. That means these two methods are going to be executed at the same time by using two different threads. As these two methods are executed at the same time, that means two threads access the get instance property parallelly, right? Now let us move to the get instance property implementation. Right, this is the implementation of get instance property. Right, this get instance property code is not thread safe because The way we have written the code, two different threads can evaluate the condition instance equals to null at the same time, and the both the threads at the same time found the condition to be true, right? And when this condition is true for both the thread, that means at that time two different instances of the singleton class will be created, which violates the singleton design principle, right? So to prove this, let us run the application, right? As you can see in the above output, the counter variable value has incremented to 2, which proves that the private constructor of the singleton class executed twice, and two instances of the singleton class have been created in a multi-threaded environment. Now let us understand the different approaches to make the singleton class as thread-safe. Let us go back to the presentation. What is lazy initialization in singleton design pattern? In our example, until and unless we invoke the static get instance property of the singleton class, the singleton instance is not going to be created. That means when we invoke the static get instance property of the singleton class, then only the singleton instance is created. This delay of singleton object creation is called lazy initialization or on-demand initialization in singleton design pattern. How to use multiple threads in singleton design pattern? The lazy initialization, that is the on-demand object creation of the singleton class, works fine when we invoke the get instance property in a single-threaded environment. But in a multi-threaded environment, it will not work as expected. In a multi-threaded environment, the lazy initialization or the on-demand object initialization may end up creating multiple instances or object of the singleton class when multiple threads invoke the get instance property of the singleton class parallelly, and that we already discussed in our previous example. How to implement a thread-safe singleton design pattern in C#? We can use lock in C# to control the thread race condition in a multi-threaded environment. Along with lock, we have other options are also available to control the thread race condition that we will discuss in our next video, right? In this video, I'm going to discuss how to use lock to handle singleton instance in a multi-threaded environment. Implementation of thread-safe singleton design pattern in C# using lock. Let us see how to implement the thread-safe singleton design pattern in C# using locks to handle the multi-threaded environment. The point that you need to remember is lock is the best option to handle the singleton instance. Using lock, we can synchronize the method so that only one thread can access it at any given point of time. So let us move to Visual Studio and see how to implement thread-safe singleton design pattern in C# using lock. First, we need to create a private static read-only object. Private static read-only object. Let's give the name as instance lock equals to new object, right? So once we create the private static read-only object, once we create the static read-only object, then we need to lock the shared resource. To do so, we need to create a lock block by using the lock keyword and by specifying the static read-only object. And within the lock block, we need to write the shared resource, that is the singleton object creation logic. That is, so I'm creating one lock block, and within the lock block, we need to write the singleton object creation logic, right? That's it, right? We are done with our implementation. Now run the application and see the output. Yes, we are getting the counter value as 1, right? Now you can see the counter variable value as 1, which means the private constructor is executed only once. That means only one instance of the singleton class is created in a multi-threaded environment, right? But the above code implementation using lock solves the multi-threaded issue, right? So we are not getting the multi-threaded issue at the moment, but the problem is that it will slow down your application, And the reason is only one thread can access the get instance property at any point of time, right? We can overcome this problem by using the double checked locking mechanism. Let us see how to implement double checked locking mechanism, right? So if instance equals to null, okay, right? So in the double check locking mechanism, first we will check whether the instance is null or not. If not, then only we will synchronize the method, else we will simply return the instance. Now run the application and see the output. Yes, we are getting the output as expected. You can see only one instance of the singleton class is created, and this version will give you better performance than the previous version. Now I hope you understand how to implement Thread-safe Singleton class in C#. Let us go back to the presentation. What next? In the next video, I'm going to discuss lazy versus eager loading in singleton design pattern with examples. Here in this video, I try to explain the Thread-safe Singleton design pattern in C#. In case you need the code and text version of this video, then the link for the same is provided in the video description section. Thank you for watching this video.